Well, beta, let's start another topic that is registration. Total about 63 questions are there and 81 MCQs, okay, on this registration. So, before starting this topic, some important amendments you must keep in mind. I brought that notes of amendment. Just a minute. Okay, so important amendment for registration, we are going to mainly section 22, section 23, section 24, section 24. These three sections are very important, okay, regarding to requirement of registration. Now the next important point here you must keep in mind that yes, procedure and that deemed registration theoretical discussion you must have to do, and I have covered question on every aspect of this chapter, okay, and that is registration. Done, beta? Chalo, let's start. Now before going ahead, there are certain amendments in section 22. What are those amendments? As you know, the threshold for amendment is 20 lakhs, but in special category of state is 10 lakhs. But what is the amendment? Now, government, okay, added one proviso where, okay, some special category of state can increase the threshold up to 20 lakhs. Hence, today, in 10 lakhs, okay, only four states are there. Okay, four state, now, yes, Manipur. मेरे साथ आप भी पढ़ो, मणिपुर मिजोरम ओके, त्रिपुरा एंड नागालैंड. ओके, सो दीज आर द फोर स्टेट अंडर 10 लैक्स. नाउ फॉर ओके, हाउ टू रिमेंबर, MMT टू नागालैंड, मेक माय ट्रिप टू नागालैंड. ओके, सो मणिपुर, मिजोरम, त्रिपुरा एंड नागालैंड, इन दिस फोर स्टेट 10 लैक्स लिमिट अप्लीकेबल फॉर गुड्स एज वेल एज फॉर सर्विसेज. सो ओके, गुड्स और सर्विसेज दोनों को, फॉर गुड्स एज वेल एज सर्विसेज. नाउ रिमेनिंग ऑल अदर स्टेट इन 20 लैक्स नॉर्मल स्टेट एंड रिमेनिंग ऑल अदर कैटेगरी ऑफ स्टेट, स्पेशल कैटेगरी ऑफ स्टेट आर कवर्ड. ऑल अदर अदर special category of states are covered. ठीक है, now in 20 lakhs, but this 20 lakhs threshold is for services as well as for goods. services as well as for goods. But by executing the power under section 23, executing the power under section 23, is it clear? Government has increased the threshold from 20 lakhs to 40 lakhs only for goods. Only for goods. Only for goods. Okay. So goods ke liye government has increased the threshold. Then, so this 20 for this four state. Okay, this notification is not applicable. It is for 10 lakhs limit available for these four state goods as well as services. But okay, under section 22. Come on, under section 22. Read with section 23. Section 23 limit is increased from 20 lakhs to 40 lakhs by giving notification. This notification number is very important. You have to remember 10/2019. Notification 10/2019 threshold is increased from here 10/2019 dated. Ye jo aaya tha, ye March mein aaya tha, dated on 7th March 19. 7th March 19. So 7th March 19, before election, Modi ji has given one package to small dealer and they increased the threshold for supply of goods. And that supply of goods, up to 40 lakhs. Now, notification number 10/2019, which you have to remember, which increased the threshold from 20 to 40 lakhs, has some condition. First, exclusively engage in supply of goods, that means anyway not engage in supply of services. That is important condition. Anyway not engage in supply of services. In supply of services matlab you are not engaged in supply of taxable service. Second, exempt service or non-taxable service. Whatever the nature of service, anyway you are not engaged in the supply of service. Really a imaginary situation. Why I am saying this imaginary situation? See, this threshold sirf naam ke liye diya unhone. Kya kehte hain? Anyway you are not engaged in supply of services. Specially I talk about interest. Interest on loan, advances or deposits. Interest on loan, advances or deposit. Beta, as per the definition of service, if you remember, definition of service, it is a service, supply of service, because receipt of interest on loan, advances or deposit, yahan pe in the nature of service. मुझे नहीं लगता कोई ऐसा बंदा होगा जिसका एफडी पे या डिपॉजिट का या लोन का कोई इंटरेस्ट नहीं होगा. एटलीस्ट सेविंग अकाउंट का तो इंटरेस्ट होगा, और सेविंग अकाउंट अगेन डिपॉजिट्स. एंड डिपॉजिट इंटरेस्ट होगा तो ना उसे भी ये थ्रेशोल्ड नहीं मिलेगा. एंड व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस विच आई वॉन्ट टू से, इन कंपोजिशन स्कीम एंड इन थ्रेशोल्ड. In composition scheme, they have specifically said, there is a circular, and in circular they specifically said, don't consider interest on loan, advances or deposit for calculation of aggregate turnover. There is a specific circular, while calculating the aggregate turnover, don't consider interest. But in threshold, now there is a notification. I have referred this notification in some question. I think question number, just a minute. If you see, then notification number 12/2017, and this notification says in threshold interest to be added, interest to be added, to be added. Okay, so this is a basic difference. In composition scheme, circular says interest on loan advances or deposit should not be considered. वहाँ consider नहीं करना है. But for calculation of threshold, aggregate turnover, okay, aggregate turnover, no doubt, okay, it based on aggregate turnover you have to consider, and you have to consider this interest. So this is a very big difference. Means, okay, if you are earning any interest on loan or advances or deposit, okay, you are eligible for threshold only up to 20 lakhs, only up to 20 lakhs, and not that increased threshold 40 lakhs. I hope you already have seen my amendment. Okay, because one of the condition of increased threshold that anyway you are not engaged in the supply of service, exclusively you are supplying the goods, okay, then this threshold is available. Second, this now, if you are liable to register under section 24, okay, if you fall under any clause of section 24, matlab reverse charge or CTP, NRTP, interstate supply, then this threshold is not available. Then third, you should not supply pan masala, tobacco and etc. Next, okay, for some state this threshold is not applicable, which I am going to explain later on. And you opted for voluntary registration. So there are, okay, four conditions for this, okay, threshold. Practically, I believe that this threshold is not beneficial, or is not beneficial, not, okay, the proper word, not get benefited by every dealer. Okay, कि भाई इसका benefit dealer को मिलेगा ही नहीं, कहीं ना कहीं interest रहेगा ही, bank interest, saving account पे interest पे रहेगा. Okay, तो practically speaking, yes. I don't think so, okay, it would be more benefited to the small dealer. It just, okay, a Modi government announcement to make happy a small dealer, but technically it is, these benefits is not passed on to the all dealers, whatever it may be. Okay, see, another important point which I am going to explain. In section 22, threshold is 20 lakhs for goods or services, for goods as well as services, not 40 lakhs, but ha. This 40 lakhs limit is increased, okay, this 40 lakhs limit is increased, okay, by executing the power through section 23, okay, 23 notification 10/2019, okay, this notification is given with various condition, which is practically impossible to follow all those conditions, but whatever it may be. So in my questionnaire, I have solved the question by taking a turnover limit of 20 lakhs at most of the places, at most of the places, by taking threshold limit 20 lakhs. But yes, you can solve this problem with 40 lakhs limit if supply is exclusively engaged in the supply of goods. But accordingly, you have to write the note. Okay, what the note is important here, okay, we assume that all the conditions of notification 10/2019, okay, are fulfilled. So there are certain problems, there are certain questions, for example, question number 9, 18, 19, 20, 21, 29, 33. Okay, so these are boss questions, where in question he diya hua hai ki he is exclusively, matlab he is engaged in supply of goods, not use the word exclusively, engaged in supply of goods. Okay, so most of the student asking the question ki sir, why we are not taken the threshold 40 lakhs if he is engaged in the supply of goods. But a threshold 40 lakhs is available, come on, threshold 40 lakhs is available, especially if you fulfill all those conditions, anyway not engaged in supply of service. I have given the example of interest, practically is not possible for every small dealer to follow that conditions. Hence, I believe that 20 lakhs limit is mostly applicable rather than 40 lakhs. But yes, you can solve the answer with the help of 40 lakhs also. आप 40 लाख के बेस पे भी आंसर सॉल्व कर सकते हैं, ओके, डन बेटा. नाउ Next important point, okay, which I have given in amendment, that amendment table is very important. You must have to read that amendment. Okay, that, okay, for goods. Now, that means the analytical table is like this. Threshold for service. For service, 10 lakhs or 20 lakhs. For 4 state, 10 lakhs. And for all other state, 20 lakhs. 40 lakhs benefit not available, okay, for supply of services. For goods, again, exclusively engage in goods, engage in service, and second, goods plus service. So now exclusively engage in goods, then yes, threshold of 40 lakhs is available subject to conditions. If you exclusively engage in goods, again two parts. If you fulfill all conditions of notification, conditions of notification 10-2019, then 40 lakhs limit is available. Okay. Otherwise, 20 lakhs limit is available. 20 lakhs or 10 lakhs for 4 category of state, 10 lakhs limit is available. For services, notification not applicable, 20 lakhs maximum and 10 lakhs for special category of state. And for goods or services, again maximum 20 lakhs or 4 category of state, 10 lakhs. So these are the important analysis of notification 10-2009 which you must know before starting the discussion on questionnaire. Is it clear? So yes, let's start our discussion, but it's my suggestion you must see this amendment of registration which I already uploaded before starting the discussion. If you already have been seen, then it's okay, we can start the discussion. Again, I repeat, most of the questions I have solved with the help of threshold 20 lakhs, but yes, okay, you can solve it by 40 lakhs, where you must have to take the assumption that notification number 10-2019, yes, you must have to write this, notification number 10-2019, okay, is applicable, all conditions are fulfilled, then solve your answer as per 40 lakhs. Okay, let's start our discussion. The first question is... Yes, 11 company, question number 3. 11 and company, unregistered supplier under GST, want to claim ITC and collect tax, can it do so? See, first of all, he is an unregistered supplier. Now, if you read provision of section 22, okay, read that. Don't try to remember. Don't try to get a ready-made answer. Wo dhyan se padho. Section 22, open your regular book. Now, threshold up to 20 lakhs. Thereafter, section 16.1. Pause this lecture. Chapter ITC. Open that chapter, section 16.1. In section 16.1, clearly state that eligibility of ITC, you should be registered person. Come on, you should be registered person. If you are unregistered person, then you are not eligible for ITC. ITC is not available. Okay. If you want to claim the ITC, you have to apply for voluntary registration under section 25(3). Is it clear? Okay. Next, question number 4. What is the effective date of registration? Very simple answer. If you apply for registration within 30 days, then date when you liable for registration, if within 30 days. If it is not your application not within 30 days from the date when you liable for registration, then date of RC. And for voluntary registration, effective date of registration is date of your RC. These 3 points you must have to consider. Okay, chali. Next. What is the time limit for taking the registration under GST? Yes, what is the time limit? Okay, see, for this open section 25, if you want to read the book, don't try to recollect. Agar yaad aata hai to okay, but time limit within 30 days when you liable for registration under section 22 or 24, clear? 30 days ho gaya. Okay, now that 30 days, but you have to write some more points. Okay, what is that? In case of CTP and NRDP, 5 days before commencement of business, matlab 5 days before supply, that is your second point. And third, one additional point which is covered by section 25, what is that additional point? Ki if your place of supply is in territorial water, then at nearest coastal port, the state in which nearest coastal post lies, that state, in that state you have to take the registration. Okay, so this is question number 5. I have selected some questions for discussion. Okay, next, question number 7. Question number 2, definition of aggregate turnover, which already I have covered. Okay, section 26, aggregate turnover. If you remember the section, then okay, otherwise 26, aggregate turnover. All taxable supply. Okay, this is a general definition I have given, but you can directly write the definition, and that definition, yes, all taxable supply except inward supply subject to RCM, exempt supply includes 3 supply, wholly exempted, nil rated and non-taxable, export supply, and yes, interstate supply within the branch, all over India basis, come on. That word is very important, all over India basis. You have to write that all over India basis. Under same pan, India basis. Under same pan. But it's my suggestion that write the legal definition as per legal provision, all over India basis, but exclude taxes and cess also. Exclude taxes and cess also. Okay. So already we have covered that definition in composition scheme. Okay, here general definition is given, but you have to write the definition as per section, aggregate turnover. Theek hai. Now next question which I am going to cover. Yes. Question number, okay, here, just a minute beta. Okay, take it. I will keep here. Question number 8. Okay. Who are the person liable to take registration under the model of GST? Very general question, but a good question. Normally, supplier or his agent. Every supplier or his agent and who liable to pay tax. ओके उनको रजिस्ट्रेशन लेना पड़ेगा इफ देयर एग्रीगेट टर्न और एक्सीड्स कम ऑन इफ देयर एग्रीगेट टर्न और एक्सीड्स 20 लाख्स और 10 लाख्स इन केस नोटिफिकेशन 10/2019 यू मस्ट राइट आल्सो नोटिफिकेशन 10/2019 if possible 10/2019 okay if you this note if you write there then that would be more better okay 10/2019 if exclusively engaged in supply of goods and other conditions are fulfilled then registration is required on threshold 40 lakhs for 4 category of state 10 lakhs now okay under section 24 compulsory registration okay if you fulfill that conditions or falling under clause of section 24 and as per section 23 certain category of person not required to register agriculture is you exclusively engage in the supply of exempted goods or non-taxable goods, or your service exclusively under the RCM. So if you write this complete answer on this straightforward question, that would be more better. Don't just write 10 lakhs or 20 lakhs or very simple answer ki every person who is liable to pay tax is required to register. No. First, section 22, okay, special category of state, then 23, certain person not required to register, 24, compulsory registration, notification 10-2019, this 4.5 points required, okay, for the purpose of, okay, liability of person to get registered. Okay, done. Question number 12. If a person is operating in a different state with the same PAN number, can he operate with single registration? No. State-wise, separate registration is needed. Use the same PAN, but registration is state-wise. Okay. Now, next question number 14. Mr. Ashwin is a farmer with annual turnover in relation to agriculture of rupees 15 lakhs 50,000 lakhs. Since agriculture income is exempt from GST, however, Mr. Ashwin also supplies plastic bags worth rupees 5 lakh 50,000, being a taxable supplier along with his crop, charges separately for this. Is Mr. Ashwin is required to register under GST? Advice. See, I repeat, there is no clarification about that, whether agriculture turnover to be considered in aggregate turnover or not. Because for calculation of threshold, it may be 20 lakhs, it may be 40 lakhs, it may be 10 lakhs, whatever it may be. For calculation of threshold, we have to take aggregate turnover. Okay, in aggregate turnover, yes, exempt supply to be added. And agriculture turnover is under exempt supply. So technically speaking, we should consider aggregate agriculture turnover for calculating aggregate turnover. For example, I am agriculturist, my agriculture turnover is 19 lakhs and my other taxable turnover is only 2 lakhs. But for calculation of aggregate turnover, I have to take agriculture turnover for consideration. But section 23 said, if you are agriculturist, then that would not be considered, okay, for registration. There is a confusion, yet there is no clarity about whether we should take, okay, registration and whether we have to add agriculture turnover in our aggregate turnover. So in this example, I have considered that aggregate turnover does not include exempt supply. Aggregate turnover includes exempt supply. So I have added that agriculture turnover and required to register. But in same question which I have covered later on, मैंने बाद में cover किया है. I have not added agriculture income turnover because there is no clarity. So I have solved this question in both the way. Come on, I have solved this question in both the way. In exam also, अगर उन्होंने agriculture turnover दिया है, तो मैं आपको यही suggest करूँगा कि accordingly you have to solve. Okay, if your aggregate turnover is less than 20 lakhs, more than 20 lakhs, whatever it would be, so you must have to consider accordingly. So aggregate turnover mein maine jo hai, okay, ye isme to agriculture income exclude kiya hai, isliye likha hai ki no need to register under GST. Lekin aage aur ek problem aayega jisme maine kaha hai ki it should be added. To dono way se answer diya hai. So there is no clarity regarding to agriculture turnover. So it by suggestion ki accordingly you must see and write the notes in exam. If you are adding in aggregate turnover, then write the note accordingly ki it is exempt supply and should be added in aggregate turnover. If you are not adding in aggregate turnover, agriculture turnover, then refer section 23 refer karo and said as per section 23 agriculture should not include their agriculture turnover. So you have to decide. Okay, next question number 15. A dealer X has two offices, one in Delhi, another in Haryana. The aggregate turnover of both the offices 25 lakhs. Determine whether Mr. X required to register under GST. Yes, you have to take aggregate turnover more than 20 lakhs, you required to GST. Here I consider your threshold 20 lakhs and I have not applied notification number 10-2019. So you have to write the notes accordingly. We assume that any of the condition of 10-2019 is not satisfied, hence threshold is 20 lakhs and not 40 lakhs. Okay, that is important for our discussion. Next. Question number 16. Rohan Oils Punjab is engaged in supply of machine oil as well as petrol. Supply of petrol is not leviable to GST, but supply of machine oil is taxable. Examine whether Rohan Oils is required to obtain registration under GST. See, aggregate turnover includes exempt supply. Legal proof. Aggregate turnover includes exempt supply. Exempt supply includes non-taxable supply as per the definition. So, okay, petrol is non-taxable supply. It should be added in aggregate turnover. Come on, it should be added in aggregate turnover. So, okay, it should be petrol turnover to be considered for calculating aggregate turnover. Your answer should be like this. Take care. Next question number 17. Mohini Enterprises has appointed Mr. Bestford and Associate as his agent. All the supplies of goods are made by Bestford and Associate as the agent of Mohini Enterprises. Examine whether the supplies has been included in computation of aggregate turnover in order to determine the liability to get registered under GST ICAI. Now, in this problem, I am going to follow my six basic fundas. First, analyze the question. First, analysis. Are you ready? Don't try to recollect anything. Question, a very good question. Analysis. Second, legal provision. Third, question with legal provision. Fourth, read the answer. And try to present it. Fifth, scope of question and try to present it. Okay, analysis. Now, Bestford, okay, doing the business through agent to customer. So now, what they want to say, Mohini Enterprises appointed Mrs. Bestford Associate and agent. Sorry. Mohini, Bestford, okay, is agent and customer. Theek hai. All the supplies of goods are made by Mrs. Bestford and Associate and agent of Mohini Enterprises. Okay. Examine whether such supply shall be included in computation of aggregate turnover to determine the liability to get registered under GST. Now, what is relevant? Aggregate turnover of Bestford, okay, we have to decide ki whatever turnover made by Bestford on the behalf of Mohini would be added in aggregate turnover of Bestford for deciding a liability of registration. Yes, for that, now go to section 22. Open your book, go to section 22, pause this lecture. Theek hai. Read that explanation. Explanation 1 for agent. This explanation said, try to understand. If you read that provision, then whatever the supply made by agent on the behalf of principal, it would be added in aggregate turnover of principal agent. It would also included in aggregate turnover of agent. That means, okay, agent's turnover includes a turnover made on the behalf of principal. Is it clear? On the behalf of principal. Done, beta? Now, next point. Theek hai. यहां पे ऑल्सो रीड सेक्शन 24, सेक्शन 24, व्हाट सेक्शन 24 सेड, सेक्शन 24 में क्लॉज मिलेगा कंपल्सरी रजिस्ट्रेशन विच इंक्लूड्स एजेंट, विच इंक्लूड्स एजेंट, गो स्टेप बाय स्टेप स्लोली, गो स्टेप बाय स्टेप स्लोली एजेंट. नाउ पॉज दिस लेक्चर, गो टू शेड्यूल 1 पैरा 3, शेड्यूल 1 पैरा 3, प्रिंसिपल टू एजेंट, प्रिंसिपल टू एजेंट, दैट सर्क्यूलर, इफ यू रिमेंबर आई एम गोइंग टू रेफर दैट सर्क्यूलर, सर्क्यूलर नंबर 73/47/2018, प्रिंसिपल एंड एजेंट एंड कंपल्सरी रजिस्ट्रेशन. रीड दिस प्रोविजन ऑफ कंपल्सरी रजिस्ट्रेशन. ओके नाउ व्हाट द प्रिंसिपल वी ऑलरेडी ओके लर्न हियर, आपको याद है, if agent is issuing their own invoice then that agent will fall under para 3, if agent is not issuing their own invoice, come on so the answer slowly, if agent is not issuing their own invoice then supply by principal to agent would not be treated as supply of para 3 and no GST is payable. So okay, where invoice of further supply issued by agent, then it would fall in para 3. Now this line is important. In this scenario, agent shall liable for compulsory registration. Compulsory registration. Yes, I got the point. Now, I am going to explain. Okay, I need your attention. Now, see. If agent is falling in para 3, so it's compulsory registration, question of threshold and etc. does not arise. Okay, to dekho, agent covered by para 3, covered by para 3, that means issuing their own invoice, then obviously, okay, required to register compulsorily under section 24. Question of threshold and question of aggregate tenure does not arise. Did you analyze this provision with me? Now, if does not fall in para 3, if it does not fall in para 3, then this agent required to register only it crosses threshold of 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs or 40 lakhs. If exclusively engaged in supply of goods, you can use 40 lakhs also. Then threshold is important as well as supply by principal to agent, a stock transfer by principal to agent would not cover as a supply. So that agent would okay to be considered threshold. Now next important point, for calculating agent's threshold, come on, what I am saying, for calculating agent's threshold you also have to consider principals, you also have to consider turnover made by agent on the behalf of principal. Yani ye agent ne principal ke behalf pe jo turnover kiya hai वो भी आपको ऐड करना पड़ेगा एज पर एक्सप्लेनेशन टू सेक्शन 22 फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग थ्रेशोल्ड. सी दिस आयरनी जब मैंने आपको सर्कुलर पढ़ाया था तो मैंने यह कहा था कि इफ एजेंट इज इश्यूइंग ओन इनवॉइस, सॉरी नॉट इश्यूइंग ओन इनवॉइस, यानी इनवॉइस ऑफ प्रिंसिपल. ध्यान से देखना, अगर एजेंट प्रिंसिपल का इनवॉइस दे रहा है, मेरी बात समझ में आई आपको, देन दिस स्टॉक ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम प्रिंसिपल टू एजेंट not liable to GST. And when agent further supply, then GST would be payable by principal and not by agent. That thing I have explained in amendment also. Do you remember that? Yes. Come on. Okay. Read that amendment provision also. So in that situation, if agent is issuing principal's invoice, then does not fall in para 3. If it does not fall in para 3, not compulsory registration, because as per circular, if agent is falling in para 3, then and only then he required to register compulsorily. So this further supply made by agent, GST would be payable by principal. But this further supply, whatever the made by agent, even though GST paid by principal, but for calculating aggregate turnover of agent, come on. For calculating aggregate turnover of agent ka aggregate turnover calculate karne ke liye, agent ka aggregate turnover calculate karne ke liye, वो ऐड किया जाएगा. अगेन आई रिपीट, सी दिस आयरनी. इवन दो जीएसटी इज पेबल बाय प्रिंसिपल ऑन सच टर्नओवर मेड बाय एजेंट, बट एज पर एक्सप्लेनेशन टू सेक्शन 22, फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग एग्रीगेट टर्नओवर ऑफ एजेंट, सच फर्दर सप्लाई वुड बी एडेड. आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड. So in such situation, using provision of explanation, yes, it would be added. It would be added in aggregate turnover. You also can write explanation to section 22. Okay, read that explanation from regular book carefully, and you can use this explanation. Next, question number 18. Mrs. Usha Enterprises has effected following supplies within the state of Maharashtra. You are required to determine whether he is required to obtain registration under GST. Intrastate supply of agriculture produce grown out of cultivation of land, family 18 lakhs. Intrastate supply of goods which are wholly exempt 7,50,000. Intrastate supply chargeable 13,50,000. Total 39 lakhs. Now, if you consider threshold here 20 lakhs, then total turnover more than 20 lakhs. If you consider threshold 40 lakhs as per 10-2019, 40 lakhs, because only engage in supply of goods, then to aggregate turnover below 40 lakhs, question of registration does not arise. I have solved this problem with threshold 20 lakhs. In exam also, if they have given only supply of goods, you can take the assumption that all conditions of notification 10-2019 are fulfilled and apply the threshold 40 lakhs straightforward. No need to confuse, no need to create any contradiction. Aap seedha 40 lakhs ka lena, agar sabhi jagah aapko supply of goods dekh raha hai. In my answer, I have taken 20 lakhs threshold. Okay, because I believe that practically it is not possible that any supplier is not engaged in any way supply of services. So, okay, I suggest you, for example, if all transaction related to supply of goods, sabhi transaction supply of goods ke hai, then you can use notification 10-2009 threshold 40 lakhs. Okay, but my answer is based on 20 lakhs. If I consider 20 lakhs, then what are other issues? What are other issues? Again, agriculture produce, exempt supply and charge. No doubt, for a calculation of aggregate turnover, exempt supply I am going to add. Chargeable supply I am going to add. But what about agriculture produce? There is no clarity, as I already told you in question number 14. So in this problem, I have not considered agriculture produce, and accordingly I have given author note. Okay. And turnover, again, 21 lakhs, which exceeds 20 lakhs required to register. Wait. Intrastate. Okay. So in this case, I have not considered agriculture produce, and accordingly I have given the note. But it is not like that ki agriculture turnover should not be added. Another interpretation, another school of thought, it should be added in aggregate turnover, because aggregate turnover includes exim supply of it. And exim supply includes only exim which are agriculture produce. तो ऐड करना भी चाहिए, लेकिन क्लैरिटी नहीं है. लास्ट क्वेश्चन सर, व्हाट वी डू इन एग्जाम. मैं आपको सजेस्ट करूंगा, अगर एग्रीकल्चर का टर्नओवर दिया है तो इट्स बेटर टू ऐड, टेक्निकली स्पीकिंग टू ऐड. ओके, इवन तो मैंने यहाँ ऐड नहीं किया होगा क्योंकि मैंने दोनों व्यू दिए हैं, लेकिन आप ऐड करो तो एग्जाम में ज़्यादा बेटर रहेगा, ठीक है. एंड और अगर आप ऐड नहीं कर रहे हो तो उसके हिसाब से आप नोट्स दे दो, ठीक है. नेक्स्ट बेटा, क्वेश्चन नंबर 21. शगुन स्टार्टेड सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स इन वसई, सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स महाराष्ट्र फ्रॉम 1 जनवरी 2020. हर टर्नओवर एक्सीड्स 20 लाख्स ऑन 25th जनवरी. However, she did not apply for registration. Determine the amount of penalty, if any, that may be imposed on Shagun on 31st March 2020 if the tax evaded by her as on the said date on account of failure to obtain registration, 1,26,000. Now, again in this question, assume that I am taking threshold 20 lakhs. Only supply of goods is given. Okay. You can take a threshold 40 lakhs, but question is not on registration. In question, they itself said ki didn't apply for registration. So question mein khud hi kaha hai ki didn't apply for registration. Matlab questionnaire, okay, a person who asking the question is also considering the limit 20 lakhs. The question, the main issue of the question is penalty. If you read the chapter of offense and penalties, pause this lecture, go to section 122, offense and penalties. Section 122, offense and penalties. Then it is clearly mentioned that if you fail to take a registration, then penalty is, yes, 10,000, correct, 10,000, or amount equivalent to tax evaded, whichever is higher. So, okay, here amount of tax evaded is 1,26,000, and this amount of penalty would be payable. Another question is not related to registration, but okay, both the questions are together I have taken. Now the second one. Sagar, managing director at Acom Solution Limited, is issued a summon to appear before central tax officer to produce the books of accounts to Telecom Solution Limited in an inquiry conducted on the said company. Determine the amount of penalty, if any, that may be imposed on Sagar if he fails to appear before central excise officer. So again, in the chapter of offense and penalties, open that chapter. There is a specific penalty under section 122 subsection 3. I repeat, section 122 subsection 3. Where you fails to appear before authorized officer after issuing the summon, then penalty is leviable up to 25,000. Have you read that provision? Okay, so this is the penalty regarding to not giving books of account or not appearing before the officer. Thereafter, question number 22. Rishabh Enterprises, a sole proprietorship firm, started air conditioning restaurant in Vihar, Maharashtra, in the month of February wherein customers are served cooked food as well as cold drink non-alcoholic beverages. In March, the firm opened a liquor shop in Raipur, Uttarakhand for trading alcoholic liquor for human consumption. Determine whether Rishabh Enterprises is liable to register under GST with the help of following information. Serving cooked food and cold drinks and non-alcoholic beverages in a restaurant. Sale of alcoholic liquor for human consumption in Uttarakhand. Interest received from bank on fixed deposit and export of packed food items from restaurant in Maharashtra. Excluding GST, you are required to provide, matlab all the data is giving excluding GST. Okay. Let's analyze the question carefully. Now, okay, here Rishabh Enterprises. Rishabh Enterprises having restaurant, also serving drink including beverages and alcoholic liquor. Second, selling alcohol in different state alcohol, and next also doing export and earning interest. This is the analysis. Now, scope, what we have to do in this question, what is the requirement? Now, determine whether Rishabh Enterprises is liable to registration. Liability to register, you have to fix. Now, third, legal provision. I personally believe you must read definition of aggregate turnover, definition of exempt supply, that also important for notes, exempt supply. Also, there is one notification, okay, which I have referred here, and that notification number 12-2017 related to exemption. Notification 12-2017 and aggregate turnover. Now, let's connect the case study with connect the question with legal provision. Now, if you have seen the definition of aggregate turnover includes what? So, aggregate turnover, okay, all taxable supply, exempt supply. Definition of exempt supply includes wholly exempt, nil rate, as well as non-taxable. Then, all over India PAN basis, even though one in Maharashtra and another in Uttarakhand. So, all over India PAN basis. What is important here? Aggregate turnover includes exempt supply also and export supply. Also export supply. Second one, exempt supply includes wholly exempt, nil rate and non-taxable. Let's analyze. Don't see the answer. Okay. Wholly exempt, nil rate and non-taxable. Non-taxable supply is alcohol. That means even though in Uttarakhand, Raipur, okay, don't go in detail of that. So, alcohol is non-taxable supply. Even though it is chargeable under VAT, CST, but for calculation of aggregate turnover of GST, you have to consider that turnover of alcohol. Clear? Then notification 12-2020 about the exemption. What this notification, that mega exemption which we have seen? Do you remember that exemption, different exemptions are given in exemption chapter? Notification 12-2017. Interest on loan इंटरेस्ट ऑन लोन एडवांसेस और डिपॉजिट्स इज एग्जम. नाउ इंटरेस्ट ऑन लोन इज अ सर्विस बट एग्जम. इट्स अ सर्विस बट एग्जम. ओके नाउ व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन बिफोर अस इन दिस एरिया. द इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. ओके इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फॉर डिस्कशन. इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फॉर डिस्कशन. व्हाट इज दैट इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन? कि वेदर इंटरेस्ट टू बी कंसिडर फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग एग्रीगेट टर्नओवर फॉर थ्रेशोल्ड. सी इन कंपोजिशन स्कीम. इन कंपोजिशन स्कीम एंड थ्रेशोल्ड. थ्रेशोल्ड इन कंपोजिशन स्कीम देर इज अ सर्क्यूलर एंड दैट सर्क्यूलर स्पेसिफिकली सेड इंटरेस्ट और डिस्काउंट ऑन लोन एडवांसेस. लोन एडवांसेस और डिपॉजिट शुड बी एक्सक्लूडेड फॉर कैलकुलेशन ऑफ 150 लाख. फॉर कैलकुलेशन ऑफ 150 लाख. ओके बट फॉर थ्रेशोल्ड. बट फॉर थ्रेशोल्ड द अनदर वन. ओके देयर इज नो सच क्लैरिफिकेशन. दैट मीन्स ओके दिस इंटरेस्ट. ओके दिस इंटरेस्ट टू बी इंक्लूडेड. ओके इंक्लूडेड इन एग्रीगेट टर्नओवर एज इट इज एग्जम सप्लाई. एज इट इज एग्जम सप्लाई. सो ओके दिस इज द एनालिसिस. नाउ फिफ्थ स्टेप. रीड द आंसर और ट्राई टू सॉल्व इट बाय यूर सेल्फ. ओके सो सी ऑल द लीगल प्रोविजन आई हैव रिटन. डेफिनेशन ऑफ एग्रीगेट टर्नओवर सेक्शन 22. थ्रेशोल्ड. एग्जम सप्लाई. Aggregate turnover. Then I have done discussion, and here the threshold is 20 lakhs. Question of 40 lakhs does not arise because restaurant is a service, interest is a service. So here, if you make the total cumulative total, okay, see the way of presentation. Then, okay, try to identify which thing is important for presentation. The total turnover is 22.50 lakhs. So your conclusion should be this interest is important. This notification number, okay, if you remember, then okay, you can write that conclusion. Ki become liable for registration. Become liable for registration. Okay. This is question number 23. With the help of following information, in case of Messrs. Jayant Enterprises, Jaipur, Rajasthan, for the year 1718. Determine aggregate turnover for the purpose of registration. Okay. Sale of diesel on which sales tax is levied by Rajasthan government. Supply of food after completion of job work from the place of Jayant Enterprises directly by principal. Export supply to England. Supply to its own additional place of business in Rajasthan. Outward supply on which GST to be paid by recipient under reverse charge. A very good question. There are various issues, okay, covered in this problem, and really a very good question. Now, let's analyze the situation with the help of, okay, given facts, diesel, non-taxable supply, Don't see the answer. Don't jump on the answer. Okay, go step by step. Supply of goods after completion of job work for the place of Jayant Enterprises and acted as a job worker. Export supply to England. Okay. Supply to its own additional place of business and a stock transfer. And this stock transfer is in Rajasthan. And fifth number. Outward supply on which GST is to be levied by recipient under reverse charge. See, before going First step, analysis of the question. Before going ahead, let's analyze. In the question, they are given non-taxable supply, job work supply. Third, they have given export turnover. Next, stock transfer, transfer within state. And next, stock transfer within state. And next, turnover of RCM. Turnover of RCM. Okay. A legal provision which is important for us. Come on. First, definition of aggregate turnover. Don't leave it. Okay. You have to read that definition again. Okay. From the point of view of this question. Okay. What this question demands from that definition. Okay. That is important. Aggregate turnover. Also, you have to refer section 22. Also, you have to refer explanation to section 22. Next, a job work reference is given. As I told you, whatever the reference comes, you must read that topic or overlook that topic, a job worker's topic. Then, yes, stock transfer is there. For stock transfer, you have to read para 2. Of schedule 1 and RCM, turnover of RCM, this what they said, outward supply on which GST to be paid by recipient, okay. Now that RCM provision, are you ready with all these provisions? Pause this lecture, read all this provision carefully. This is the way of your analysis. Don't ignore. Okay, even though this topic related to registration, theoretical topic, easy topic, but don't ignore. Okay, so that RCM provision is also important. Done, beta? Okay, now what a necessary information we need from this definition, because you have read this definition number of times. But in the context of this question, what unnecessary information you need from aggregate turnover? Also, you have to read the definition of exempt supply. That exempt supply definition is also important. Now, I can conclude that this non-taxable supply I have to add in aggregate turnover. About job work, dekhte, because about job work, a definition of aggregate turnover or exempt supply doesn't give any specific reference. Then another export supply, it should be added in aggregate turnover. Stock transfer within the state, let's discuss, and RCM. So these three things are important in this question. Okay, what to do? Before going ahead, okay, read section 22, that is threshold, that about threshold, and explanation to section 22. Explanation to section 22. See, so now third, okay, yahan pe step, I have linked the question with legal provision. Yes, this step already we have done, humne abhi complete kiya. This explanation to 22 is important for our discussion. A second explanation to section 22. Have you read that? Nahi read kiya hoga? Mere liye wait mat karna. Are you waiting for me? No, no. Open the book. Read that explanation, especially for job work. What that explanation said, read it carefully. These are very important to write the notes. Whatever the analysis of the questions, whatever the analysis of legal provision I have done here, these are all of your notes, which is very important, beta. Done? So, explanation says, in case of job worker, or, okay, if you read that expression carefully, then if any job worker do outward supply on the behalf of principal, on the behalf of principal, it should not be added in his aggregate turnover. Matlab aggregate turnover of job worker. Aggregate turnover of job worker. So, okay, the turnover of Jhand Enterprises as a job worker should not be added in aggregate turnover. Okay, and for that you have to write that explanation too. Next step, why I said read para 2 of Schedule 1? Para 2 of Schedule 1 said any supply of goods as a stock transfer. Have you read that para? If you don't remember, pause this lecture. Any transfer of goods to related party or deemed distinct person in the course of business, it would be deemed supply and it would be your turnover. Because, okay, definition of turnover, aggregate turnover first, all taxable supply. That word is very important. All taxable supply of goods or services except, okay, under RCM. Okay, except inward supply under RCM. Inward supply. Under RCM. ठीक है, so all taxable supply includes, yes, stock transfer, supply, all taxable supply means what? Whatever the definition of supply covered, that under section 71A, 71B or 71C, schedule 1, okay, that should be added. So if there is a stock transfer with deemed distinct person, then it should be added. Now, in given facts of the case, they said the another branch in Rajasthan. So, Jhand Enterprises itself in Rajasthan and another branch also in Rajasthan. Also, they have not given the data that whether that another branch is registered under separately registered in within the same state or not. भाई वो दूसरी ब्रांच सेम स्टेट में सेपरेटली रजिस्टर्ड है या नहीं है, दे आर नॉट गिवन क्लियरली डेटा. सो ओके, वी अज्यूम दैट द अनादर ब्रांच इज नॉट अ डीडीपी बिकॉज नॉट इन डिफरेंट स्टेट एज वेल एज नॉट सेपरेटली रजिस्टर्ड बिकॉज नो एडिशनल फैक्ट्स इन द प्रॉब्लम. तो ओके, दैट स्टॉक ट्रांसफर अंडर रूल 55 चालान एंड दैट इज नॉट अ सप्लाई, दैट इज नॉट अ सप्लाई. So you have to write the note accordingly. As per para 1, okay, supply of stock transfer to deemed distinct person would be treated as a supply. In given case, a branch in same state and not separately registered. Now, as per the amendment, you can separately register the branch, but not separately registered. So in such situation, yes, it's not subject to duty. It's not subject to a supply. Now, last word is very important. What is that? Outward supply on which GST to be paid by recipient. That means, okay, what our definition says, our definition of aggregate turnover said, if you see it carefully, definition of aggregate turnover said that all taxable supply, come on, what this definition said, all taxable supply except inward supply subject to RCM. Now, in problem, they have given outward supply. Exclusion is only for inward supply and not for outward supply. So, if you are doing outward supply and recipient is liable, come on, if you are doing outward supply and recipient is liable, then it would be added in your aggregate turnover. Even though recipient is liable to pay tax, but it's your turnover, your supply. So, wo add hoga. सिर्फ इनवर्ड सप्लाई एक्सक्लूड किया जाएगा. ओके, अगर आपका आउटवर्ड सप्लाई अंडर आरसीएम है तो वो एक्सक्लूड नहीं किया जाएगा. अ वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन. तो ये ऐड होगा, तो बेटा ये भी ऐड होगा, जॉब वर्क वाला ऐड नहीं होगा, एक्सपोर्ट वाला ऐड होगा, ये नहीं होगा और लास्ट वाला ऐड होगा. Total 7 lakh. Total turnover is 7 lakhs. And again, whether notification number 10-2019, that is threshold 40 lakhs, is applicable in this problem, the last question. I think no. Why? Because they are providing job work service. And if they engage in service,
question of notification 10-2019 is not applicable here. That is a threshold up to 40 lakhs. Is it clear? If you can write that additional note, then that would be more better. Okay. So this is the analysis we have done for question number 23.
So beta, read these notes carefully. Okay, and also fix in your mind what notes to be written, to what extent to be written, which section is relevant, okay, for writing the notes. Okay, so we have done question number 23. Question number 24 on similar line, you can do that. Then question number 25. State the category of person not liable for registration. Any person, okay, who is not liable for registration? Section 23 mostly. Agriculture is exclusive, engage in only exempt supply, nil rate supply, and also write, okay, agriculture is engage in supplying goods, exempt supply, non-taxable supply, that is okay. And also you have to write, see that notification is there, where if you exclusively engage in non-taxable supply, exclusively engage in non-taxable supply, yes, sorry. Exclusively engage in such outward supply which is subject to RCM and recipient is liable to pay, then no need to register under GST. So read that section 23 carefully for this question. Yes. Question number 26. State which of the following suppliers are liable to register. Agent supplying goods on the behalf of some other taxable person and its aggregate turnover does not exceed 20 lakhs during the financial year. If this agent covered by para 3 of schedule 1 issuing own invoice, then compulsory registration under section 24. And if this agent is not covered under compulsory registration, then he required to register if their aggregate turnover exceeds 20 lakhs. And third point, in the agent's turnover, we have to include principal turnover as per explanation 1 to section 22. Okay, so you can also write that third point, as per explanation to section 22, we have to include turnover of the principal. Agriculture is second one. An agriculturist who is only engaged in supply of produce out of cultivation of land. Section 23, agriculturist no need to register under GST. Okay. Question number 28. SP Limited of Bangalore, Karnataka has effected intrastate supplies of taxable goods amounting 14 lakhs. Between 31st October to 1st, till 31st October. On 1st November, it has effected interstate supply of taxable goods amounting to 2,50,000. SP Limited is of opinion that it is not required to get registered under GST law since its aggregate turnover not likely to exceed 20 lakhs in financial 17-18. As consultant of the company, it required to advise relating to registration requirement. Okay, advice relating to registration requirement. Obviously, if there is an interstate supply, it's fall under compulsory registration section 24 and required to register. And within 30 days, okay, within 30 days, yes, he has to apply for registration from the date when he become liable. And within 30 days from the 1st of November, he has to apply for registration. Simple as answer question number 28. So section 24 is relevant for this. And section 24, compulsory registration, and 25, procedure for registration. Just I want to change one thing in this question. Instead of supply of goods, taxable goods, if I take service, then he is engaged in interstate supply of service. Read section 24 carefully. Open your regular book. The first condition for compulsory registration that he must engage in, if any person engage in interstate supply, then required to register compulsorily. Well, in this question, I want to make one small change. And what is that? If a person engage in supply of service, or you can say interstate supply of service, then is it necessary to do compulsory registration? What is your answer? No. Don't just listen me. Open that topic of registration. Just open it. Pause this lecture and open it. Go to section 24. And read that notification. There is one exceptional notification. And that exceptional notification said, in case of, and do your research, don't believe in me also. Okay, I always prefer if you do your research and interpret something new. Okay. Don't be a dump, always a teacher is saying and you are just listening. Okay, go step by step. So section 24, clause A, interstate supply, compulsory registration, there is one exception, and for services. If you see that exception for services, they can take a threshold of 20 lakhs or 10 lakhs, whatever it may be, even though doing, I repeat, even though doing interstate supply. So the answer would be different if you supply a services also. Okay. The next question is that notification 10/2017 for services. Next question, question number 29 is based on that. He is engaged in service, then what to do? Then he can take a threshold. Okay, question number 29, you can read that. Question number 30, it was asked in MTV mock test paper. Mr. X of Mumbai often participate in a jewelry exhibition at trade fair in Delhi, which is organized every year in the month of February. Mr. X applied for registration in January. Okay, and proper officer demanded an advance deposit of tax amount equivalent to exhibition, participation in exhibition, advance tax deposit, and next on estimated tax liability. You are required to examine whether any advance tax to be paid by Mr. X at the time of obtaining registration, CA final mock test paper 2018. Well, beta, okay, from the words you must remember CTP, casual taxable person. The answer is yes. You must have to write definition of CTP in your own language. Okay, temporarily he is going to other state where he don't have any establishment for supplying goods or services. This is a casual taxable person. Next, section 27, in case of CTP,
5 days before registration. Also, registration is available only after payment of advance tax liability on estimated amount and all those steps you have to write. Okay, to see carefully section 222 definition of casual taxable person, section 27, when registration to be sought, and registration is for 90 days. So all these important things you must have to write in this question. Well, the next question, question number 31. AB Private Limited, Pune, provide housekeeping services. The company supplies its services exclusively through e-commerce website owned and managed by Hitech India Private Limited, Pune. The turnover of AB Private Limited in current financial year is 18 lakhs. Advise AB Private Limited as to whether they are required to obtain GST registration. Will your advice be any different if AB Private Limited sells ready-made garments exclusively through the e-commerce website owned and managed by Hitech India Private Limited? Let's analyze the question. Analysis. AB Private Limited. Private Limited, housekeeping services. Don't jump, don't try to recollect anything, don't try to recollect. Go slowly, step by step, housekeeping services. Using ECO, the name of ECO, Hitech India Private Limited. Okay, so AB Private Limited, housekeeping, using ECO, supplying the services. Now, the question number A and B, what if AB Private Limited supply ready-made garments? What if AB Private Limited supply ready-made garments? Ready-made garments. Second, what is the requirement? Whether AB Private Limited required to register or not. Third, legal provision. What do you think? Legal provision, is it very simple in one line or two lines that housekeeping services, and you just remember housekeeping, 95 notified. So how you are going to structure your answer? They have not asked RCM or 95 ECO payment. This said whether AB required to register or not, who is providing housekeeping services? Is it the answer in one line? What you expect? No better. For that, you have to refer section 22, section 24. Then, this section 24, read with notification number, 65/2017. Yes, collect the provision. Open your regular book. Then, definition of ECO, electronic commerce operator, 245, electronic commerce 244, then section 95, in that the housekeeping service is notified in notification number 17/2017, and on this basis you have to write your answer. First, section 22. Section 22, your threshold is 20 lakhs or 10 lakhs because you are providing the services. But section 24, compulsory registration. What section 24 said? Pause my lecture, read provisions regarding to ECO. Yes, go ahead. Okay, section 24 said, okay, ECO required to register compulsorily. Okay, second one, 9.5 ECO also required to register compulsorily. 9.5 ECO compulsory registration. Third, if you read the provision, then if any supplier supplying the goods through ECO, okay, supplying the goods through ECO to customer, and this ECO required to collect TCS, required to collect TCS, then supplier has to register compulsorily. I repeat, supplier has to register compulsorily. Okay, but this compulsory registration of supplier is needed only in a case where he is supplying through ECO, he is supplying through ECO, he is required to deduct or collect TCS. Collect TCS. Also, there is one exception that this registration is not necessary. If you read that, okay, exception notification number, okay, here 65/2017, no need to remember notification number, but read that, at least read that. Okay, this restriction not applicable for services. That means, okay, a services can be supplied. I repeat, a services can be supplied through ECO even though they require to deduct TCS. I repeat, this compulsory registration, come on, this compulsory registration to supplier of goods only, or supplier of the goods, not for services. Okay, only in a case where ECO required to deduct TCS. Now, read the provision of reverse charge 17-2000, okay, housekeeping services notified under section 9.5. Reverse charge where 100% liability is on ECO, you must have to write this. Okay, 100% liability is on what beta? ECO. Clear? So, in such case, what is our question? Our question whether AB required to register under GST? Of housekeeping service provider. So after analyzing with all this section, after writing the legal provision of all this section, your answer should be AB not required to register under GST till threshold of 20 lakhs is available. Why? Because not fall under compulsory registration. Because not supplying through, okay, because his service notified under 9.5. Okay, so in such case, ECO required to register compulsory and housekeeping service provider can take a threshold of 20 lakhs or 10 lakhs, whatever it may be. So, and another question is, what if engage in ready-made garments? If he supplied the ready-made garments, goods, 9.5 is not applicable because 9.5 only for services, if you remember. Second one, also compulsory notification under section 24, okay, read with 65/2017, that is applicable to goods. Only services are excluded. So your answer should be like this. So read the answer carefully what I have given in, okay, questionnaire. A very lengthy answers, I obviously here very lengthy answer. Okay, to summarize it properly, section 22, no need to, okay, write 3 lines, 4 lines, just write a threshold is available up to 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs. Okay, 24 compulsory registration, who supplies the goods through ECO. Then notification, okay, 65/2017, only in one line that a supplier of service can take a threshold even though supplying through ECO, who is liable to deduct TCS, but I need all these points with section if possible. Okay, next definition of ECO is reference of 9.5. I also need that reference in one line. Definition of ECO and electronic commerce. This is an extra information. If you want to write, it's okay. Otherwise, not needed. Huh. But housekeeping services are notified under section 9.5. Then your conclusion. Okay, so yes, this is examination question. Even though suggested answer is okay, you find very lengthy, but it's my suggestion that yes, you have to fix the points in one or two lines, you have to answer it accordingly. Okay, beta. So this is question, this is a very good question, you must go for it. Next, question number 39. It's a good question for our discussion. Yes, question number 39, CA final may 18 new syllabus. Pre-instance in an unregistered dealer on 10th August 2017, aggregate turnover of pre-instance exceeds 20 lakhs. The firm applied for registration on 27th August. So on 10th August, the turnover exceeds 20 lakhs. The firm applied for registration on 27th August 2017 and was granted registration by 1st September 2017. Okay. Under CGST rules 2017, you are required to advise Pari and Sons as what is the effective date of registration in its case, and also sought your advice regarding period of issuance of revised tax invoice. Now, as per legal provision, section 22 about threshold and section 25. First, after analysis, legal provision, very simple problem, hence no need to do a lot analysis on that. But yes, within 30 days from the date when you are liable for registration, required to apply for registration. And yes, I think 10th is the date when liable, then Pari and Sons liable for registration, and 27th is a date of application. RC received on 1st September. Then he is said to be a registered person from 10th of August. And from 10th of August till 1st September, date of RC, he has to issue the revised invoice as per section 31. And in this section, you have to refer three sections. In this question, you have to refer three sections, section 22, section 25, that is within 30 days. Thereafter, section 31, read with rule, that is revised tax invoice. And last, your conclusion. But again, a lengthy answer. You have to write precisely. So in this answer, section 22, one line, section 25, second line, section after 25, section 31, revised tax invoice, and effective date of registration, these 3-4 points are very important, for this question. Thereafter, question number 40. SAM Limited has two manufacturing units located in Maharashtra. One unit located in Nashik is engaged in the manufacture of fabrics, and another unit located in Nagpur is engaged in the manufacture of textiles. Can separate registration be granted for its two units, though located in same state? Why I am taking this question? This question is based on amendment. As you know, the law is already amendment. As per CGST Amendment Act 2018, which is applicable for your attempt, yes, earlier, before amendment, in same state you are eligible for another registration only if you have a separate business vertical. Agar aapka separate business vertical hoga, then and only then you can take a separate registration, otherwise not. But this condition of separate business vertical is withdrawn. I repeat, this condition of separate business vertical is withdrawn. And now, as per amendment, one proviso is added in section 25, and as per amendment, you can take a multiple registration in same state. So, another registration in same state is allowed as per amendments. Thereafter, question number 43. SNP Private Limited Coimbatore exclusively manufacture and sells products Z which is exempt from GST, wide notification issued under relevant GST legislation. Company sells Z only with Tamil Nadu. Okay. The turnover of the company in previous year was rupees 55 lakhs. Company expect the sales to grow by 20% in current year. Owing to growing demand for the product, company decided to increase its production capacity and purchase additional machine manufacturing Z on 1/7/2020. The purchase price of the capital goods 20 lakhs, exclusive of GST 18%. However, effective from 1st November, exemption available on Z withdrawn by central government and GST at rate 12% was imposed thereon. The turnover of the company for half year up to 30th September was 40 lakhs. Board of Director of SNP Private Limited want to know whether they have to register under GST. I have covered only part A. Okay. Part B regarding to eligibility of ITC on capital goods. But this chapter is related to registration, hence I have covered part A. Okay. The previous year turnover. Okay, let's analyze the fact. This is a good case study. Analysis. First, taxpayer and SNP manufactured goods Z, which is exempted goods, third, only intrastate supply, supply in the state of Tamil Nadu, fourth, planning to increase production capacity, fifth, machine purchase, machine purchase 20 lakhs plus GST on 1/7/2020, 20 lakhs plus GST. Exemption is withdrawn. Withdrawn on 1st November. November 20. GST rate and GST 12%. Fifth, turnover up to 30th September. Turnover up to 30th September, 40 lakhs. 40 lakhs. Now, requirement. Requirement to do. Do. Only registration. Actually, this problem is incomplete because only I have taken registration part. Okay, in this problem. So, ये ITC part जो है, इसका मैंने नहीं लिया क्योंकि हम chapter registration में हैं. Registration or not. Now, for deciding the scope of my question requirement, I got the requirement. So, I will not divert the question towards switching. Yes, switching is happened in this question. पहले exempted था, फिर taxable हुआ. This is the switching. But my scope is not to decide the ITC. हाँ, for ITC, then section 18, subsection 1, clause D, and last 1 year purchase. I will refer all those things, but okay, मुझे अभी वो नहीं है. तो, okay, required legal provision for deciding registration. तो legal provision, I need section 22, 23, 24. Okay, whether I have to register or not, these sections are important. With definition of aggregate turnover, aggregate turnover. And last, okay, exempted, definition of exempted supply. Exempted supply. So when in maximum question of this chapter registration, these provisions are used. इसलिए मैं आपको कहूँगा कि चैप्टर के सामने ही ओके ये सेक्शन लिख लो. मतलब नो नीड टू रिमेंबर ऑल दी सेक्शंस, बट दीज सेक्शंस आर इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर डिसाइडिंग वेदर टू रजिस्टर और नॉट. एंड इफ यू कोट द क्वेश्चंस ओके इन योर आंसर्स, देन डेफिनेटली इट विल क्रिएट गुड इंप्रेशन. सो इट माई सजेशन कि इन एवरी चैप्टर आइडेंटिफाई विच सेक्शंस आर इम्पॉर्टेंट, विच वी मस्ट हैव टू राइट वाइल राइटिंग द नोट्स. ओके सो डेफिनेटली इट विल हेल्प यू. सो यस. And also, I will consider new notification number 10-2017. Okay, so if that 40 lakhs threshold on certain conditions. Section 22 said, okay, normally threshold is 20 lakhs, but okay, for some state, for category of state, 10 lakhs for goods as well as services. 23, in certain cases, no registration is required. 24, compulsory registration. ठीक है. एग्रीगेट टर्न ओवर डेफिनेशन एग्जम्प्टेड सप्लाई एक्सेट्रा. नाउ एग्रीगेट टर्न ओवर इंक्लूड्स एग्जम सप्लाई. एग्जम सप्लाई, एग्जम सप्लाई डेफिनेशन इंक्लूड्स ओनली एग्जम नील रेट एंड नॉन टैक्सेबल. एंड नोटिफिकेशन 10-2003 फॉर सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स. कम ऑन, फॉर सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स, गुड्स थ्रेशोल्ड इज अप टू 40 लैक्स. फॉर सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स थ्रेशोल्ड इज अप टू 40 लैक्स. Clear? Okay. So, yes. All these are the provision. I hope watch this lecture, read it carefully. Okay. And then connect with the facts given in question. Now, these are the facts. Now, while analyzing the facts, you have taken extract of various information. But which information is relevant to solve our answer? You must identify that. आपको ये पता होना चाहिए कि हमारे को जो हमें जो आंसर देना है उसके लिए कौन सी इन्फॉर्मेशन ही जरूरी है. कभी कभी कुछ इन्फॉर्मेशन एक्स्ट्रा भी होती है. टैक्स पेयर, ओके. एग्जम्प्टेड गुड्स अर्लियर, ओनली इंट्रा स्टेट सप्लाई. इज दिस इंफॉर्मेशन इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर टेकिंग अवर डिसीजन. सी okay, this information is important. I will take this information okay later on. Intrastate supply, planning to increase the production, not relevant. Machine purchase, not relevant to decide registration, because we just have to consider aggregate turnover. Okay, but this information is important for ITC in case of switching, but we are not in on the issue of switching. We are just okay confined to the scope of registration. Exemption withdrawn, okay, on 1st 11 2020. And turnover up to October. So, okay, this information is important. This information is important. Okay, to dekho. Now, earlier up to 1st 11 2020, my goods under exemption. Now taxable. Switching is done. Okay, switching is done. Okay, but there is a requirement of registration on 1st. Up to 30th November. My turnover 40 lakhs. Now, he is engaged in supply of goods Z only. So, here, you have to write the answer. Okay, so, earlier exempted goods and now taxable goods. Now, it is taxable goods from 1st November. The simple question. And you must have to answer, should we consider 20 lakhs after it become 20, okay, after it become taxable? Kya hame 20 lakh ya 40 lakh, whatever is the threshold, us din se lena chahiye, jis din wo taxable hua? Or we also have to consider turnover which made under exemption, which made under exemption. What do you think? Do you expect I should answer? See, if you are taking definition of aggregate turnover, which is very important, then in aggregate turnover, come on, okay, I need your attention. In aggregate turnover, turnover of exempt goods to be considered, also to be considered. So, whatever the turnover made, okay, up to September, that also to be added in aggregate turnover, even though your goods become taxable from 1st of November. 1st of November. That means, yes, your aggregate turnover exceeds 20 lakhs, or if you satisfy the condition of notification 10-2019, then threshold is 40 lakhs. I have given the answer on the basis of 20 lakhs. But in exam, you also can write ki if all the conditions of 10-2019 is fulfilled, then threshold is available 40 lakhs because SSC is exclusively engaged in supply of goods. Accordingly, you can write. Okay, so you can change the answer. Don't just stuck on my answer given in questionnaires. Every time I am saying to you, main frequently aapko ye bata raha hu ki you, if SSC is exclusively engaged in supply of goods and fulfill all the conditions of 10-2019, then yes, you can go with that option, 40 lakhs. So this turnover only up to September, 30th September. So definitely up to 1st November, turnover is more than 40 lakhs. So if you are giving the answer on the basis of notification 10-2019, then also answer would be same. You also have to register, under GST. So this information is important and this would be your answer, I personally believe. So they go 22-23. That you are under exemption, hence not required to register, but your turnover exceeds 20 lakhs, you must have to apply within 30 days. But if you are going to refer 10-2019, then give the answer accordingly. Okay, in that case also registration requirement is there, okay, because turnover is given only up to September and switching is done on 1st November, the definitely turnover is more than 40 lakhs. Okay, beta, done. Next, turn to question number 56. Answer the following issues pertaining to registration chapter. Does aggregate turnover includes value of inward supplies received on which RCM is payable? No. Okay, inward supply is not includable. What if dealer migrate with wrong PAN as the status of firm was changed from proprietorship to partnership? Okay, if dealer is migrate from wrong PAN, matlab old PAN, then he has to apply for new registration. Yeah, new registration is important. Taxable person, business is many state, all supplies are below 10 lakhs. He makes an interstate supply from one state. Is it liable for registration? Yes. Okay, because there is an interstate supply if he engage in the supply of goods. You must write this answer. Yes, registration is necessary. Interstate supply of goods, supplies of goods, then compulsory registration is necessary. You must add this word, interstate supplies of the goods. Next, can we use provisional GSTN or do we get new GSTN? Can we start using provisional GSTN till new one is issued? Okay, so dekho, provisional GSTN is converted into final GSTN within 90 days. Yes, provisional GSTN can be used till you get the final GSTN.
Okay,
so now next. Come to question number 60. Is based on notification 10-2019. I have taken one problem. Okay, that up to 40 lakhs. Messrs. Religare Trading Corporation is engaged in supply of variety of products located in the state of Karnataka. And its turnover from the sale of the following product is as follows. Plastic chair, wooden table, TV stand, wooden shelf, office portable chair, etc. Messrs. Religare Trading Corporation need advice as regard to whether it should obtain a registration under GST Act or is there any exemption available to him. Also state whether your answer will be changed if Messrs. Religare Trading Corporation makes such supply from state of Telangana. You are required to advise him on this stating relevant provision of GST Act. Again, open your book, read that notification 10-2019 or amendment book and 10-2019. A threshold exclusively for supply of goods is available up to 40 lakhs to some state, except, okay, here Telangana. Telangana has not, yes, certain special category of state and Telangana who has not opted for 40 lakhs. And I think Puducherry is also there, who has not opted for 40 lakhs. So except these two states, just a minute, Telangana is there and Puducherry is there, and certain special category of state, they have not opted for 40 lakhs. But Assam, Himachal Pradesh and Jammu and Kashmir, unhone 40 lakhs liya hai. Other special category of state is 20 lakhs. And out of that, four special category of state, that is Manipur and Tripura, etc., for 10 lakhs. In amendment lecture, I have given detailed analysis for that and detailed table of that. Need not to remember that table, but at least ek do bar padke to bhi jaiye. So in this case, you are exclusively engaged in the supply of goods. Therefore, yes, and not doing any non-taxable supply. Also not under compulsory registration of section 24. That means you have satisfied all the conditions which is important for 10-2014. So your total turnover, is 27,54,000. You can take threshold of that. But for Telangana, applicable limit is 20 lakhs and not 40 lakhs. So in such situation, you have to require to take registration under GST. Next question number 61. Messrs. Bajaj of Maharashtra engage in taxable as well as exempt supply. Taxable as well as exempt supply of electronic goods in intrastate level. The detailed transaction carried out by Mr. Bajaj in a financial year 2019-20 are as follows. Both they are manufacturing taxable and exempt. All are intrastate level. Year 19-20. State the compliance procedure regarding registration to be complied by Mr. Bajaj on his aggregate turnover for the financial year 19-20 exceeds 20 lakhs. Would answer differ if Mr. Bajaj is engaged in interstate supply as well? No. Second, would your answer differ if Mr. Bajaj is engaged in supply of goods and services? Would answer differ if Mr. Bajaj is making intrastate supply from the state of Telangana? Would answer differ if Mr. Bajaj make a supply of service ancillary to the composite supply of goods? Okay, a good question. Okay, go step by step. Again, open amendment notes or regular book, read that notification 10-2019 carefully. That notification says threshold of 40 lakhs is available. First condition, he exclusively engage in supply of goods, not providing any non-taxable supply. Third, not providing any services. Fourth, also not following any clause of section 24. Five, a product is not tobacco, pan masala and all those, okay, ice cream and etc. And last, certain category of states cannot take, matlab, this limit is not applicable for certain category of state. Have you read that provision carefully? Okay, don't listen me. Open that book. That is important. So, if you see the first para, then he is engaged in goods only. Even though taxable as well as exempt, you have to take aggregate turnover. So, their aggregate turnover exceeds 20 lakhs, but they can take a benefit of notification 10-2019. No need to register. But if they do interstate supply, then 24, say compulsory registration, interstate taxable supply, then okay, compulsory registration. Even then notification 10-2019 not applicable. Next, would answer differ if, okay, Mr. Bajaj is engaged in supply of goods and services? Yes, then threshold only up to 20 lakhs. Then benefit of notification 10-2019 is not available. Third, would answer differ if Mr. Bajaj is making intrastate supply from the state of Telangana? Yes, for the state of Telangana, or if Mr. Bajaj is in the state of Telangana, then in that situation, the threshold available only up to 20 lakhs required to register. And last, would your answer differ if Bajaj make a supply of service ancillary to the composite supply of goods? A very, very important. I am not engaged in service, but whatever the service I am giving is a composite supply of goods, which is classifiable as a supply of goods. मैं सर्विस अलग से नहीं दे रहा हूँ, बट मेरी जो सर्विस है वो गुड्स के साथ जा रही है, इट इज़ अ कंपोजिट सप्लाई. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आई एम सेलिंग द गुड्स अलॉन्ग एंड चार्ज फ्रेट या लोडिंग अनलोडिंग चार्जेस या पैकिंग चार्जेस. सो सर्विस एलिमेंट इज देयर, बट इट इज़ अ कंपोजिट सप्लाई एंड एंटायर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इज क्लासिफाइबल एज अ सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स. देन इफ एंटायर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इज अ सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स, देन आई कैन टेक बेनिफिट ऑफ नोटिफिकेशन 10-2019 का मैं बेनिफिट ले सकता हूं, बिकॉज इवन दो देर इज अ सर्विस एलिमेंट बट इट इज अ कंपोजिट सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स, आई कैन टेक द बेनिफिट. तो मैं बेनिफिट ले सकता हूं. सी द आंसर विच आई हैव गिवन विथ नोटिफिकेशन 10-2019. ऑल द कंडीशंस आर गिवन. ओके, सो एंड स्टेप बाय स्टेप आंसर्स फॉर ऑल हैज बीन गिवन प्रॉपरली. So, good question on that notification. I have taken here question number 61. So, read this answer carefully. We have done the discussion. Okay, and see the way of presentation. Okay, beta. Next question number 62. Mr. Ismith Patel, a dealer, engaged in the supply of taxable goods having place of business in the state of Punjab, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh and Manipur. The turnover of the state for the financial year 2019-20 was as follows. Do one correction in this problem, that is important. This is not 30 lakhs, this is 3.0 lakh. This is 1.9 lakhs and this is 2.2 lakhs and 1.2 lakhs. By mistake, 30, 19, 20 and 12 lakhs is there. Okay, so you have to add a point there. So Mr. Patel approached you to advise regarding compliance of registration procedure to be made by him under GST Act. Advise him under the eyes of GST law. Okay. So here योर एग्रीगेट टर्नओवर ऑफ ऑल स्टेट, सभी स्टेट्स का मिला के आपका एग्रीगेट टर्नओवर डज नॉट एक्सीड्स 20 लैक्स और 40 लैक्स. 40 लैक्स यू आर एंगेज इन सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स, ओके, ओनली एंगेज इन सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स, एंड अज्यूम दैट यू आर नॉट डूइंग एनी इंटर स्टेट सप्लाई, देन लिमिट इज 40 लैक्स, अदरवाइज 20 लैक्स. इफ एग्रीगेट टर्नओवर डज नॉट एक्सीड्स 40 लैक्स, देन इन दैट सिचुएशन या 20 लैक्स, देन नो नीड टू रजिस्टर अंडर GST. बेटा नो नीड टू रजिस्टर अंडर GST. वेल सो बेटा ओके, हियर यू हैव टू टेक एग्रीगेट टर्नओवर ओके ऑफ ऑल स्टेट फॉर डिसाइडिंग रजिस्ट्रेशन लायबिलिटी. सो इन आंसर ऑल्सो यू हैव टू मेक द चेंज अकॉर्डिंगली. दिस इज 3 लैक्स, दिस इज 1,90,000, 2.2 लैक्स एंड 2 लैक्स. सो नॉट लायबल टू रजिस्टर. Not liable to register, not liable to register, not liable. And here also not liable to register. Come on, not liable to register, because in Manipur 10 lakhs, but our aggregate total is below 10 lakhs. If you take 3 plus 1.9 plus 2.2 plus 1.2, below 10 lakhs. So for Manipur also, okay, not liable to register. This, okay, it's a typological mistake, beta. Okay, in this problem. And this last RTP question. Happy Limited, located in Alwar, question number 63. Exclusive manufacture and sell product Shine, and which is exempt from GST. Okay, this question already, similar type of question which already we have done. Okay, that first exempt supply product Z is there. Okay, already we have done. So in this way we have completed this chapter, registration. Okay, beta. So, मेरे lectures आते रहेंगे continuous, पर मैं आपको ये कहूँगा कि आप अपनी पढ़ाई चालू रखो. जो question में आपको problem आ रहा है वो side में लिख के रखो. जब भी मेरा lecture आ जाएगा वो आप उसको refer कर सकते हैं. और www.vsmartacademy.com पे okay, कौन सा question कौन से time पे discuss किया गया है उसका भी okay, timing दिया है. तो आपको पूरा लेक्चर देखने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. जो क्वेश्चन में आपको प्रॉब्लम है वो क्वेश्चन आप डायरेक्टली जो है वो टाइम पे जाके देख सकते हो. आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड. इज़ इट क्लियर बेटा? चलो, थैंक यू.